Storyboard special from the Kyoorius Designyatra. I'm Pavni Mittal. The 9th edition of the festival brought together a host of acclaimed designers who shed light on the changing nature of the business and what brands should do to stay ahead of the curve. One such designer at Kyoorius was the founding creative partner and chief creative officer of Pearlfisher, Jonathan Ford, who I caught up with to understand the role of packaging, the challenge of working with iconic brands, and the 7-year itch in a brand's journey. Listen in. Welcome to Storyboard.
Thank you.
First question I want to ask you, you mentioned in your session that design is the most important aspect of branding. Do you say this because you're in the business, or do you believe that marketers and those in, say, advertising also share the same sentiment?
Well, I think that you only have to look at how a brand presents itself these days and to see that everything from the physical or digital expression of that brand has to be designed. And old client mentality was designers design stuff and advertising advertise stuff. Well, now everyone talks about communications, but you just have to look at what's happening with these communications agencies, which are investing in designers because they know that in order to create communications, design has to be the way that you express a brand. So yes, I do believe that design is the most important medium. It's just that it gets lost sometimes in the quest for other things that that are probably buzzwords or too much of a fixation in a particular area like digital. Well, digital still has to be designed.
So what element of design do you think plays the most important part? If I had to ask you to break it down even further.
Yeah, well, I would distill it down to truth and desire.
Okay.
I think you have to build any brand on a sense of truth. And then you have to use design to be the bridge between that truth and creating constant desirability. So that is the way that any brand, be it a digital brand, a consumer brand, or a financial brand, can all come back to that very sort of core foundation, and design is the vehicle for expressing that brand truth.
So in packaging, how does it go? Is utility the starting point and then comes creativity, or does creativity determine everything else and utility comes in the end?
Yes, I think that's an interesting question. Depends how you interpret the word utility. But I would say, again, it comes back to the truth of the brand.
Okay.
One chocolate product can be very similar to another chocolate product, the actual functional aspect of the enjoyment of that chocolate. But then that other brand versus your brand may have zero brand assets, whereas the one you may be working on has got maybe 150 years worth. And it is knowing what to do with those brand assets, the way that you are accentuating them, choosing the right ones, maybe adding something new into it, that I think is that makes the big difference and can help build brand value between two very similar products.
So could you give me an example of a brand where packaging has helped grow the business?
Sure. Well, I think you just have to look at a brand like Absolut Vodka that started, 30 years ago. At the very beginning of its inception, there was a bottle shape that became the cornerstone of all the advertising at the time.
Yeah.
And that is an iconic bottle shape. And I think the fact that it disrupted the category of vodka, if the whole story was different, the look and feel was different, became a major part of the kind of the iconic advertising at the time, helped get that brand on the map. One of my first clients was Green and Black's chocolate, and the packaging redesign that we did, over the last 20 years, there've been three phases of really major upgrades to that, and it has taken it from being a corner shop brand to being an international brand.
You find it difficult to communicate and convince marketers, especially today, to go with, say, an outlandish idea. You find that a bit of a struggle?
Again, it depends on the client. I think we try to spend a lot of time working with like-minded clients, people that value design. If they don't value design, or they've got a different agenda, then they're probably not
right
for us.
But how many clients are there who do that?
I think there's quite a few.
Okay.
I think nowadays, with the young entrepreneurs who are challenging the more established brands, they know that design is their tool for making a big message. They can change the category by having a very expressive language. But I also work with chairmen of companies that have been around for a long time, and they know that they have to change with the times. Yeah. And so they are very respectful of what design can do for them, and they see design as an investment and not a cost.
What is the difference in strategy when you work with, say, a challenger brand and an iconic brand, and which is easier?
Well, they can. There are different strategies. Mm-hmm. Design strategy for a challenger brand will be about disruption. It will be about new codes of graphic expression, and that opens up a whole host of opportunities, graphic and physical shape, and also into communication, because they know that once you've created a brand asset, it has to live beyond, say, packaging, for example. Mm-hmm. So challenging, disrupting the spirit of the new. Whereas icons, you need to treasure, or you need to update, or you need to reinvent. And that's a strategy kind of line, and it all depends on how well that iconic brand is doing, whether you nurture something or reinvent it.
When would you say is the right time for a brand to go in for a redesign? Is it a 7-year itch, or is there a method to that madness?
There probably is a cycle, and I think there is. It's probably driven by the needs of the brand in the way that the world is changing around it. And I would say I'm a bit cynical about the fact that in some companies people change brands too fast, and that's to do with, for example, not people moving in their role. Brand management roles classically change every 2 years, so the new person coming in wants to change something. That's too fast. But I would say anywhere after sort of 7 years, 7 to 10 years, it would probably be a good idea to check and see if your brand is still strong in amongst everything else.
Let's take a quick break here. When we come back, Fahrenheit 212's Todd Rovac talks data and design.